a lot of times in instructional design or project management, when we're dealing with a project and we're trying to, you know, work with the client to figure out what their needs are, there's something called the triple constraint, which is a combination of scope and quality, time and cost. And what that means is that, you know, I'm trying to balance these things as I'm working with the client to come up with an appropriate solution. So, you know, on one end, they're going to tell me, okay, well, we don't want to spend a lot of money, and I know that could significantly decrease the quality. All of these three things are really interconnected with each other. And so, you know, during the first, like, usually the first meeting I have with a client, like maybe the first 30 to 60 minutes, while they're talking, in my head, I'm thinking of these things. I'm thinking of the scope and the quality of the project. I'm thinking, how long is it going to take? And I'm thinking, how much is it going to cost? Because as they're telling me things, usually by the end of that first meeting, they don't need an exact figure by the end of that hour meeting, but they like me to say, hey, this is going to cost around $50,000. You know, I'm just guessing. I'm going to write up a proposal and give you an exact estimate. But in my head, I'm kind of thinking based on what you're asking for. Okay. So what I usually do then is I take what they've told me, you know, that what kind of quality do they want? What kind of time frame do they want? What kind of cost? And I usually will come up with some kind of proposal for them that gives them like anywhere from 2 to 4 options. So obviously this depends on the size of the project, the client, how much I know about them and everything, but I usually try to get like a 2 to 4 option. So on my screen here, for those of you listening, I'll just kind of read it. I have an example of just 2 versions. So if I'm talking with a client and they're telling me they want some computer-based training, you know, and usually when they talk to me, the first thing they say is that they want the world, right? They want everything. But they don't want to pay for it. At least they don't want to pay top dollar for it, and they don't want it to take a long time. Okay, so we have to, you know, come down a little bit. So what I try to do is I try to tell them, hey, this is what the top version, this is what the best, the coolest thing in the world is going to cost. This is something, and then I'll give them a lower version, and I'll say, you know, this will pretty much is going to meet your most of your goals, maybe not all of them, but most of them, and it's going to cost this much less and take this much shorter to complete. So, and then they can pick and choose what they really want to do. So on the, you know, the example here, I'm just using, like, I have some computer-based training that I'm going to develop for them. That's what they want. They've kind of given me an idea. They want some computer-based training. So, you know, I have, for the scope and quality, version 1, which is our low-end version, would have limited, really no video, because video is expensive to produce, probably limited narration, maybe some narration in it, and, you know, limited interaction. It'll have some interaction, basic interaction, like, you know, maybe a drag and drop type game, but it's really not going to have like anything like really virtual or anything of that nature, like nothing gaming as far as, you know, that goes. And for a cost for that, I have $25,000. This is just like, you know, a 1 or 2 hour training, and it'll take about 3 months to complete. So that's my version 1. Then version 2 that I have for them, I have full simulation, video, tons of interactions. I have that it's going to take 5 months, so it's going to take almost double the time, and it's going to cost $45,000, which is almost double the cost. Now, these are just completely made up numbers, not realistic whatsoever, but you get the idea that what I'm doing is I'm giving them options, and I'm really looking at that triple constraint, the scope, the time and the cost, and coming up with some kind of estimate and really telling them what I can do for them. It's really how this works. You really have to figure out, how do I balance this on a project? You have to do it before a client commits to something, because at that point you're stuck. If you commit that you're going to do something in 6 months and you realize after the first month that it's going to take you 8, you have a big problem. You know, you're dealing with scope creep on your end, and that's a big problem. So, you know, you really have to figure out this before before a client signs a contract. It's something that takes experience. So a new instructional designer is going to have a lot more issues with this than someone else, but it's something that you learn about. And, you know, I try to really, as I'm talking with the client, I can give them rough estimates off the top of my head in that, you know, that 30-minute conversation that we have together. I try to give them that rough estimate about, you know, what I think it's going to cost, give or take 15% or something like that, so they can have some rough ideas in their head. And then I present them the options. I like the options, because it gives the client time to really think about, what do they really want to do? What's really going to meet their needs? And that's the triple constraint. Thank you.